This is a video to show you about the quiz system in WAMAP, just kind of what it looks like, where to look for things. So I'm going to go ahead and open up a section here and go to the quiz, and it'll take you to this landing page that tells you the points possible, due date, any special instructions that a quiz might have, and you just click Start Assessment, and it'll take you in there. Now the first thing you'll notice is your score. The number of questions answered right now is 0 out of 10. You can click this question right here and it will bring you up a list of the questions. You can go in any order. You don't have to go in any particular order. It is recommended you start with number 1. They're usually the easier ones. But if you get stumped, you can skip it, go to the next question. Down here you'll have question help, which this one actually has a video you can watch in case you're not sure how to do it. You can also post it to the forum and it'll put a post in there that has the question and allows other people to answer your question about it. We'll go over some of the submissions here in a minute. Over here on the right side, you'll notice right now your score is 0 out of 10 points. This little circular arrow with a 3 tells you you have 3 tries on this question. So you'll get to submit and answer 3 times. And then after the 3rd try, if you're wrong, it'll show you the correct answer. This little double arrow here with the 4 says you can try a similar question 4 or more times. So you'll be able to regenerate that. In this case, it's just going to be 4, 4 times for this one. And then details, if you click that, it'll tell you some details. We'll do that in a second after we submit something. So let's go ahead and just type in an answer right now. So I'm just going to put in 2 for the base and the exponent. Those are incorrect answers, but I just want to show you what it looks like. So it says our score is 0 out of 10, and you can either go to the next question, or you can just retry by entering other answers. Now notice here on the right, it's brought this number of tries down to 2. So now I only have 2 remaining tries on this question. I can try a similar question still 4 times. So I'm just going to submit that a couple times. It tells me answers haven't changed. Kind of know that already. Let's go and change one of them. So submit. Notice 1 to 2 tries remaining. If you hit the details, it knows I didn't change anything on part 1. So I still have 2 tries remaining on part 1. Part 2 is now down to only 1 try remaining. Alright, let's go ahead and put in a 1 and a 2 on this. Submit. Both are still incorrect. It tells me I still have 0 out of 5, but 1 try remaining on part 1. So you can actually even just submit one part without submitting the other part, and it'll still let you try on those. Here it lets you view the answer. So the answer there was 4. I still have tries on this one, so it's not showing the answer just yet. Let's go and change that back to 2. Hit submit. And then it'll show me the answer on that. So the answer here is -7. The answer here was 4. Now, if you get to the end and you've gotten these answers incorrect, you can click this try a similar question. And it'll give you the question again, but with different numbers. So it allows you 3 more tries. You can see on the right, 3 tries remaining. And now you can try a similar question only 3 more times. So you get total of 5, the first one that pops up, and then 4 more reattempts after that. If it's a different setting, you'll see a different number here on the side. And now you can go and enter it. So this time, I'm going to go ahead and just enter that base -8, show you submit. So that part's correct. You'll see green when it's correct. And you'll also notice on the details, that one's correct. I still have 3 tries remaining on part 2. So if I was confused on part 2, I can go ahead and do part 1, try to get that, and then come back and do part 2. The exponent, I'm just going to put in the correct answer there, 7. So once you see green check marks, that's a good thing. Both of these are correct answers, and you can go ahead and go on to the next question after that. So you can just hit next question. Similar type of thing. Like I say, you can skip around on some of these. Not all of them have videos. Some do, some don't. So it just kind of depends on the question whether or not there's going to be a video help button there. But all of these kind of do the same thing, just fill in the blanks as you go. Now there'll be another video on specifically questions that involve the equation editor and things like that. But this is just to get you used to the format of what you're seeing as you take the quiz. One last thing to note is the score up here. So now notice there's a score of 10 out of 100. So we've got one question correct, 1 out of 10 answered. And if you click this, it'll show you which questions are correct, which ones you still have left to do on these. Your score is updated as you answer questions. There's no save button or submit at the final end of the quiz or anything like that. Just as you work, it saves all your scores. So just keep track of what your score is, how many questions you've answered, any reattempts that you have on these questions as you go.